بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. دي برادر سيستر، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome all of you wherever you are. And welcome you again on your program Fatwa Life. My first question tonight, the brother is asking, his father is sick, is about to die. The doctors, they said that the father will live the life, no doubt, even if under the machines. But these instruments, they cause infections. Maybe it'll add a few days or hours. It depends on whatever Allah has written in His book. Can we take the instrument, turn it off? We are confused. The answer, when the patient get to no return journey with the human calculations, the experts calculate, the doctors, and these instruments cannot bring him back to life, cannot reduce his pain or infection, then should not keep it. Keeping it at that time is not obligatory and it's not rejected. And you look at his will, if he had a will on this, or to his family around him, if he did not make a will on this. And this with consultation with the expert of the doctors who are taking care of his situation. They all has to be considered what is more lenient to the patient at this stage of his life. And Allah is more knowledgeable and known, know everything. Ameen. This meaning is there from the permanent fatwa in and any other, all the other fiqh committees. But you have to be not to rush into this decision and the concern. Maybe the doctor wants to use this equipment on some other patient. It has to be with other experts, other doctors. The second question, I have some money in the bank for my checking account for my daughters to help them in marriage. It goes 1 year. Do I pay the zakah? Of course, it reached the year. It reduced automatically. If you take the zakah, it will be reduced. It will finish after a while. I heard a fatwa that you can pay 10% of the profit or the income. The answer, first of all, ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make your goodness to your daughters as a way from the hellfire. We give you the glad tidings that our mother Aisha said, a woman came with two daughters, asking money. She didn't find nothing but one date. So I gave it to her. So I divided it between two of her daughters. And she didn't eat from it. And she got up. Then the Prophet ﷺ came in. So I told him what happened. He said, whomever is been hit with these women, ladies, and was good to them, there will be a seal from the hellfire. In the hadith of Ibn Abbas with Tabrani, and he spent on them and he made them, and there will be a cover, or they don't think of it that it is whomever Allah is testing him with having two daughters. It's not like Allah gave him calamity. These are not calamity, these are beautiful gifts from Allah Azza wa Jal. So anybody, no matter what is the reason you brought it, except for a debt, or to make it waqf in the sake of Allah. So only with those specific things, don't make the zakah. But I tell you, look back at what you mentioned, that the money is going to reduce. First of all, no money will reduce from charity, and this is the same of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he don't lie. No man, no money will spend, don't fear poverty. Because once you get to a certain level, you're not going to be able to pay zakah. But I, maybe you need to take it to an Islamic bank where you put it on something to investment, whatever you get, it'll be a profit, and you pay the zakah, and Allah increase in your money. Because the person who put in a chicken, if he is not eating the riba, he is given that riba, because he's given the bank an asset that he could use to give loans, and the bank will take the profit by himself. So if Allah gave you an Islamic bank that invests in this money, so take it to him. You protect your principal money. And what is said about all the rumors about the Islamic institutions, let's say it is true, and these books are doubtful. With the normal bank, it is 100% haram. So you have two choices. One thing for certain is haram, the other one doubtful. Take the lease of the problems. من أجل أن تدفع أعظمهما. الذي يشوش علينا من المصرف الإسلامي يدفعنا إلى المصرف التقليدي المستجير بعمل عند قربته كالمستجير من الرمضاء إلى الغد. لا ينبغي لأحد أن يعتب على نور فيه ظلمة ما دام لم يحصل له نور لا ظلمة فيه.
The zakah.
The zakah is not only on the, but also with the the zakah is in all accounts. It's not only in the principle only, but on all the income that comes out of it too.
Mm-hmm. الجاري عبارة عن قرض لدى الجهة التي أودعت عندها هذا المال، وهي جهة مهيئة وغنية قادرة على رد القرض في أي لحظة، فكأن المحفوظ في جهة فتزكي نظام المغفير إذا بلغ نصابا. النصاب ما يسمى
النصاب is what is
85
of gold.
السؤال التالي، نعم حبيبنا يقول أعمل في شركة أمازون.
Somebody is asking that I work in Amazon. It has different companies that follow it. What is look is permissible? It has some that is not halal, not permissible. I work as a programmer for the under for the company, and it has different contract with different companies, some bad companies, some bad armies. So the shares in this, it's different. I have a salary and about to leave, but I have shares. So my share is already mixed. What do I do? This is from the mixed income that you can take it after you purify it. You did not take your given to because you are a worker in that area. To get rid of what you think that is equal, the percentage that is for.
وانت ملكت الاسهم، لو انت تتخلص من نسبه ال 10% دي مما يقابل هذه النسبه المحرمه، لا تتركها للجهه الام القائمه على هذا العمل، لكن تاخذها وتتخلص منها بتوجيهها الى المصارف العامه، ويرجى ان يثاب على هذا ثواب العفه عن الحق. فانت تحرك
just like you purify your money with the charity, the same thing from the extra stuff. The Prophet said this sale has lagu nonsense talk and wrong saying, so purify it with charity. So how do you know? It's taking the best of your judgment. You could you need to do your homework by asking the expert, an accountant, and everybody else. One of our brothers, the kind people.
حذر الرزق الحلال وتخليص أموال الشركات التي يقوم عليها والدهم من الشرائع والمحرمات والعقود الربوية ونحوها. يقول أرباح
the profits that come from investing the interest. See, we have 5 million in profits, in interest. It came in the principal. So that 5% came another million. That million. You add to the 5 million. So if the other one is my percentage because I worked hard.
الشعب الذي حبته أنا لم أفعل في أرضك المحرمة يا ترى أعمل فيه.
So what do I do? The haram or the haram and the interest of it. The one that's haram, you don't take it, you don't hold it. You can hold it, but you're not owner to it. I could own it, and you don't have it. The one that are stolen. The one who steals is the one who is holding, but he don't own it. And the one who owns it, he owns the money, but he is not an holder of it. The money that's confiscated and the oppression area, they are controlling, but the other one own it, but don't hold it. The Sharia did not make the haram something you could hold. Like, didn't tell you that if you steal, you own it. You hold it in your hand, but it's not yours. What you take it forcefully, you hold it in your hand, but you don't own it. What you take it from interest, you hold it now or in account. But you are not an owner. So those who invest in the haram and use that money in that profit, we knew that principle is it like I work. So he said that I read in some of the fatwa committees that some of the scholars, they think that the Prophet has to do with the work, so it will be honor for that person who invested it, even if it is from forbidden sources, because this is from the work he did. And the answer, because the hadith, the kharaj wa daman, whatever he's going to be for the matter, then it is for him. Can you take that opinion? Or no? The answer, if what is meant to be kind to your friend and take them to repentance and to take them to Allah early, then it is okay. Maybe. At least this is something some of the scholars they say, even though there is in it to soften the people who wanted to repent. But if you want it to do yourself, you are the one who want to benefit from this prophet, so I don't see it for you. Because with Allah, you are from those who have good Islam and good holiness of Islam. You don't need a fatwa of the people who are softened their heart. You're not among the non-Muslims that wanted to soften their heart to Islam. But all this dispute for those who repented from riba, and we're talking about what's before repentance. Someone who continue take loans and take interest and invest it and keep doing it. We don't give him that he take the fatwa that will make him want to do more haram, more things that are not permissible. Because Allah did not allow those who hold it to own it, didn't make the riba to own the interest. Wallahu alam. A simple question, but it is what we all go through. A woman said that I go to my son to take him to a clinic. There is a woman that has a big family. She helped me in reservation. I give her some money, and I give her anyway, whether she's helped me or not. I look at her condition and I give her what helps her. And I know she don't prefer me or somebody who were before me. just to add my name to the list, because I might come late. I call her and she put my name. Is this bribery? If her role is just to add your name to the list, you did not take no one before you, and you are paid this money to help her, and you give it to her either way, whether she helped you or not, nothing wrong with that. Because the bribery is to take the money to have the rights of others. And Skalida added to pay the money of someone who deserves it to get his right. Because the one who has the right, he should get his right without paying for it. You want to get a permit to get a building. Everything is done. Your right is to take that permit. But if an employee refuses to give it to you unless you give him some money, this is paying the money from someone who is have the right to get this right with that bribe. So what stops you is an oppressor. So if you have to pay, you have the excuse that he is going to be sent from the contract, could be forbidden from one side and permissible from one side. From the person who forced you, that's forbidden. From your part, it is Allah, because he's eaten fire. But if you have next, you have no way to get your right except by that. Then you have an excuse, inshallah. So again, some of the contract could be forbidden from both, or permissible from both, or not permissible one part and permissible in the other. And your what you mentioned is not from bribery, as you have described. A question from Russia. The brother is asking, I heard one of your program that the person who had fatwa at the time of me to take the fatwa that the divorce did not happen in the hayd, the period and the nafasa when the woman has just gave birth. The majority Muslim, they say it is forbidden, that it's not accepted in the divorce in that period. Because the Prophet said, oh, don't that you have to divorce them only at the time that you have purified, they did not touch. Account at the time, and don't fear Allah, they don't leave unless they bring like a big sin, and whomever exceed the boundary of Allah, he have done himself wrong, that no, maybe Allah will bring something else. So it is forbidden, the divorce, but the majority in the Hanafiya, Shafi'iya, Maliki, and Hanabila, the divorce of the Bid'i, it happened. And it's counted on his people as one divorce. And this is what the Assembly of American Jurist Assembly, that the divorce at the period or period that he touched on, it is forbidden, but it happens. And for the Mufti to take the one who asked the fatwa, saying of the scholars who do not see that it happened, or he will take it to them to save the family affair. And to consider the dispute in this issue. So, if we are against a third divorce, because the first or second one, you can go back. The third one. So if you could show that permission until she marries someone else. So so if it is the third one, there is more leniency to use these criteria of having her period or she is an nifasa, meaning that she just gave birth. And the woman cannot be allowed to marry until she finishes her period of waiting and to marry the other person, not so they could enjoy it for a short period of time. No, it is a permanent marriage. Only if it is, does not stay too long, then she had the right to go back if the other husband still wants one. What about wearing gold outside and in front of the people who are not the one who allowed the face and the hand to be exposed? He allowed to expose the ring. So if you cover the hand, you cover the ring. So it looks about the dispute about the face and the palms with the agreement of all scholars that the woman who is very beautiful, she need to cover her face and hands with no doubt. That's the agreement of all scholars. Is there a form for takbir before Eid? And the extra on the Prophet ﷺ, is it bid'ah? It is very wide manner. What is explained? Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, Wa la ilham. There's also explained Allah Akbar, Allah Akbar, only twice, La ilaha illallah, Allah Akbar. The Prophet ﷺ, it is also narrated on some of the scholars who are Kabir. So it is with the, it's not from the Sunnah or Bid'ah. Don't put the Bid'ah on every dispute you have in Fiqh. But Bid'ah, that's it is, you are completely refused. It's not that far. It is allowed to take the money of the to you can pay the debt of your father from your zakah, but try to do it a little bit. Don't gather the money with you. Take his debt immediately, little by little. First of all, you cannot make the zakah on the origins or the one underneath, like the father, grandfather, or son, grandson, male or female. But to pay his debt, yes, you can pay the debt. I don't think you should put it on the part. At that time, you have extra, just from in your father's debt. Even if it is a little bit out of time. It is okay that the woman to work, even though she doesn't need it because her husband is already well. The priority in the life for the woman to stay in her house to take care of her husband and his kids. Allah said, and stay in your houses and do not put the garments of the external people. The Western woman, she is in in misery because she left the house and she wished she could have a house she stay in and a husband take care of her. You will see nowadays women, they either take their kids to a daycare center or this here and there so she could run and work and spend all that money on other things. But anyway, as far as halal or haram, if this is permissible work, and with the acceptance with the husband, no waste of the house and household chores. We do not forbid what Allah allows. But if she asks our advice, we tell her, oh, my sister, my aunt, my grandmother, my mom, if Allah allows you to stay in your house, to take care of your husband and yourself, and use your extra money in beneficial knowledge of learn the Quran, memorize it, do for your hereafter, and for knowledge. This advice is incomplete, and I do not forbid what Allah allowed. So it is with the consultation of with the husband. It's not covering her body. Someone said this is the interest halal or haram. We answered the over 10,000 mark. I think our father need to look at the list of fatwa to make him feel good and to honor him, and he's a good asker. Ibn Abbas said the best people to be is the one who comes to ask me. If I wish the flies don't go to his face, I will do. This is the honor of the biggest teachers for those who come to learn from them. I tell him, oh my dear brother, the interest of the back, it is the pure haram, that no doubt about, there's no doubt about. And anything you hear beyond that, I say that the people are saying are wrong. The fiqh committees, since 1965 and before, they all agree this is all haram, forbidden, non-permissible. When it is allowed,
the loan, you will do it with interest.
The one who takes loan could be at the time of need. So his sin is lifted, depends on what, whether he needs or not. And every person is responsible about whether he needs it or not. Can we make the adhan in one fajr and then bring the another one next? No. Do the goodness if you can of goodness. Just to pray early, it is better to be the first one to the masjid. Nowadays, with the corona and others, and the masjid don't close. But I love your interest, being the best. So come as early as possible. To go from one masjid, you came early to another. They have a reason just to go from one place to another, even to spend the time to another one, without there is a waste of that time. If you come to a masjid of sunnah and you are among the people, the first one who come, sit in it and pray whatever you can, recite whatever you can of the Quran, and mention Allah Azza wa Jal. Look and listen. Someone said the father died. He used to leave something in the safe. Now he died. Then the money became inheritance.
ودورنا بخراب الباب المنايا رفعت يده عن ماله وابن ادم يقول مالي مالي
Ibrahim said, my money, and he left from his money of what he ate or what he made sure to have kept. Maybe the question should be, if the money came in and it has extra money, what do you do? Is it to be intelligent or not? Some of them said it is. And thus, that you are being responsible at the day of judgment or in your grave about what you have. And the one who inherited is the one who is going to be asked. You're the one who have to deal with it. So if you want, which is good for you, to get rid of this extra, to take it to the public areas, maybe this is one of the things that Allah reduced on the deceased, his punishment. May Allah have mercy on all the Muslims. A question. My neighbor, they cut his leg and they buried it in a grave. These are not permissible graves. Now he is about to die. If he died, we bury him in the same grave where you have his leg, or do you do it in a different grave where the body is separated? The answer, it is not required that his corpse will be in the same grave that his leg was buried. But if it is allowed, it is good. But it's not a condition. The priority is for the Islamic cemetery. You have either cut or lahad. The lahad or the is in the Islamic grave. And you raise the grave, what is came from the, and you put like the same way like the Salam of Kamel. You can put a grave, a rock by the head to indicate where people can know it's a grave, or if you go to him, you will know how to get reached him. To have fighting games like boxing, is it allowed or not? This is important for our youth. In all sports that benefit the body and do not have harm and no corruption in the religion, it is permissible, it could be recommended or obligatory in certain times. But if this, it will lead to harm or intentional hurt, then it is not allowed. They have a decision about boxing and wrestling and the pool fighting. They found with agreement that the boxing that is exercise, it is forbidden in Sharia. Because it's based on allowing, hurting the other person to the other. And his body could do permanent harm or to death. No responsibility on the person. With the agreement and the victory part on the other side, which is all forbidden in Islam, because Allah said, don't throw yourself to destruction. Or Allah said, do not kill yourselves. Allah is more merciful. And saying of the Rasulullah, no harm to be caused. So the Sharia, they said, whoever allowed his money to himself, he said, kill me. He said, no. Someone said, I am fed up with my life. Do you kill him? And he allowed you? No. And if you did, then you are responsible. You deserve the punishment. And that's why they decide that the sport is not supposed to be called physical sport. It should not be practiced. And not to promote it, so youth will not use it. But the wrestling, well, the wrestler can help them. They think exactly to boxing, even though they are different in, because all the thing with harm is there. And because of what we mentioned, if the exercise did not cause harm, it will be to raise the awareness of self help in defense, it is okay. But to harm, it is forbidden. Can it be in the masjid? Can we do the exercise here in the masjid? If the matter of permissible, no harm, being in the masjid, it is something big. And the Ahbash, they played in the masjid of Prophet ﷺ, that's an indication of this allowance. If that does not cause what break with the Allah, more knowledgeable, and we shall continue on Monday, inshallah. Thank you.